How to talk to her if you're nervous. So you're walking down the street, maybe you're on a date, maybe you're at a party, and you see an attractive woman, or you're talking to an attractive woman that you want to make a good impression on, but you are very, very nervous. Okay, I've been in this position tons of times, I've been in a lot of dates, I've, you know, coached a lot of guys on this. And the one thing that I see is that when someone's nervous, they can't be their best self. And that's a problem because she wants to see your best self. That's why confident guys tend to do so well. So is there a solution if you're a guy who is talking to someone and, you know, you're very nervous? Is it possible to show your best self? Well, in this video, I'm gonna give you some strategies that will tell you exactly how to be someone who can at least look confident when you're talking to someone, even if you're nervous, okay? So I'm gonna give you a few tips and describe why being nervous is such a challenge and how to get over it. Okay, so let's talk about being nervous when you're talking to somebody. If you're talking to somebody and you're nervous and you're scared, what's happening is that your body's filling up with cortisol. When cortisol is running through your body, it's in fight or flight mode. So what's happening is that your body is either figuring out, it's in survival mode. It's not in a mode where, hey, I can make this cool joke, or I can say this cute line, or I can listen to her and, you know, establish a connection. It's not doing any of those things. What it is doing is it's trying to keep you alive. So what I do when I'm in this position is I just go to like a few questions that I can turn to get the conversation to a level where I start feeling comfortable, reduce that amount of cortisol that's going through my body. You know, typically this might be when you first meet someone, if it's at a party or something, you ask them where they're from. Super easy small talk question. You brought it right back to where it was before. You know it's a question they have an answer for. You know it's a question that you can follow up with. Oh, cool, how did you end up here? Or how was it there? Or whatever. So now you have some like ways of calming the cortisol down, so then you can start being yourself. So you can ask like, where are you from? Like, you know, what kinds of things do you do for fun? Like, what do you do? Who are you here with? Like, all of those things that I will ask a person normally just to get a little information about them. I start turning to those questions and I answer them myself too. Calms me a little bit down, so I'm able to get into a mode where I can start being funny and relax with this person. Because ultimately, that's what you want. You want like a relaxed, confident feel where you can lead the conversation. That's gonna make you the most desirable kind of guy to talk to. So start with some questions that you can use. The other thing too is to change your mindset surrounding the conversation. Typically when guys go in, what makes them really nervous is they start thinking, I gotta get this person to like me. Okay, that's not the right mindset you wanna have. You wanna already assume that she likes you and you're just showing yourself. Right? If you have to prove that you like her, you're gonna start saying dumb things about how you own a yacht that you don't own. You're gonna start stammering over your words and it's not gonna make you look good. What you do wanna do is you wanna be your best, most confident self, and assuming the attraction is going to help out. And you can assume the attraction by assuming that you're gonna be able to come away making that person feel just a little bit better. Don't think, oh, I gotta get this girl's phone number, I gotta get this girl to like me, or I gotta sleep with this girl. You know, if you put that kind of pressure on yourself, I can guarantee you, you're gonna get nervous. Cool, something else that you can start doing is be curious, not judgmental. What I do when I'm talking to somebody is I'm curious about what they're doing. I don't judge them, because if I start judging them, I'm gonna start judging myself. And then that's bad. You don't wanna start judging yourself while you're talking to somebody. You wanna be just in the conversation expressing yourself. So be curious about whatever it is. Doesn't matter if they disagree with you. Doesn't matter if they're doing something you don't really find terribly interesting. This is a chance for you to be curious about them. Cool, and the next thing is get comfortable talking about stuff that you're doing. Whenever I introduce myself to a group of people, basically I walk in, you know, comfortable talking about what it is I'm doing at the party, or what I'm doing that day, or if I'm on a date, you know, I talk about what I did that day as well too. You know, I get comfortable talking about myself, and that will kind of relax yourself a little bit. Now, once you do this, you have to make sure that you also ask the person questions so you can listen to what they're saying too, because listening is one of the most important skills in conversation, maybe the most important skill in conversation. And the last thing that I would recommend that you guys do to reduce nervousness is just embrace awkwardness. Awkwardness happens between even the coolest of people. I've been at parties with celebrities, models, you name it, and these are some of the most awkward people on the planet. You know, it doesn't matter how successful somebody is, they're always gonna encounter awkward situations, and that's okay. It's being cool with them and not letting it throw you off, or not going out, or not taking action because you're worried about a little bit of an awkward situation. I mean, some of the best friends I've had, some of the coolest people I've ever met, when we first met, it was awkward as hell. Dude, I could not wait to get out of that conversation, but you know what I did? I stuck in there for just a little bit longer to make it better. And honestly, some of the best women that I've dated, it was awkward at first, but I stuck with it. You know, if you're comfortable in the awkward situation, she's gonna be more comfortable too, but if you let it throw you off, guess what? She's gonna feel awkward, she's gonna wanna leave, and you probably won't be able to talk to that person again. Okay, so embrace awkwardness. It happens to everybody. Cool. Well, those are the tips that I have for being able to talk to people or an attractive woman if you're nervous. You can use this on a date. You can use this at a party. You can use this, you know, in your everyday life if you're talking to people normally. So, yeah, this is something that I train guys on all the time. So if you want to get access to my free trainings, there is a link down below. I click on that. And my name is Lloyd Dixon. Thanks for watching, you guys. Good luck out there.